Good afternoon and welcome everybody. We're about ready to start. Just a reminder to turn your cell phones, either to silent or to airplane mode or something. Thank you.
Rather, the sincerity of our faith in our lives. Grant to all of us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace and the love of the Lord be with you. May our shared peace and joy of the Lord be with you.
Yes.
guide shepherds for your people. Pour out a spirit of purpose and fortitude in your church to make these your servants worthy ministers of your altar, and armed yet gentle heralds of your gospel. We pray this in our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit in one God, both now and forever.
Amen.
Second reading is from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. I remind you to stir and to appoint the gift of God that we have through the impression of our hands. For God not gives a spirit of cowardice, but rather of power and love and self-control. So do not be ashamed of your testimony to our Lord, nor of me, a prisoner for his sake, but bear your share of hardship for the gospel with the strength that comes from God. He saved us and called us to a holy life, not according to our works, but according to his design and the grace bestowed on us in Christ Jesus before time began. But now, made manifest through the appearance of our Savior, Christ Jesus, who destroyed death, brought life and immortality to light through the gospel, for which I was appointed preacher, apostle, and teacher. On this account, I am suffering these
not his own, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away, and the wolf catches and scatters them. This is because he works for pay and has no concern for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know mine, and mine know me. Just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock, one shepherd. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord. Those ministers
bond with the presiding bishop as fellow bishops who possess the aptitude to deal with rather weighty matters of the spiritual welfare of those entrusted to us. For this reason, we direct our thoughts, especially and with great affection, to our church as one body under the protection of Mary, Our Lady of Hope, currently in need of an additional bishop, owing to the election of our former coadjutor bishop, Wieczorek, having been elected to fulfill the office of presiding bishop. In our search for someone possessing the requisite virtues, enabling him or her to shepherd these ecclesiastical responsibilities as detailed in the bylaws of our church, we accordingly turn to you, venerable brother, who by the election of the ministers of our church reflects our judgment that you are endowed with the pastoral experience, a constant champion of civil rights and social action, and to possess the qualities of character needed for taking the bond of office. Therefore, upon the certified election, by the fullness of our apostolic authority, we name and appoint you Bishop of the National Catholic Church of North America, granting you the obligations and the rights prescribed by our bylaws. In addition, we mandate that the clergy and faithful of our church be informed about this, our decree, and decision, and that they warmly welcome you as shepherd and guardian of the truth. Finally, Venerable Brother, as you set out for this new phase of your ministry, we have the utmost confidence that Mary, Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, the Mother of God, and the Mother of all believers, will look upon you with her loving confidence, and that Saints Peter, Paul, and Matthew, and other holy venerated saints of the Church in Washington, will accompany you with their prayerful intercession. Given at Golden Manors, Florida, at the Church of Holy Angels, on the 24th day of the month of September, in the year of our Lord, 2022.
Almost finished time. He said, you want to leave the harmony they gave you in the book? And I said, not really. He said, good, because I'd rather have you do your own. I hope you know it's going to be sad. So here we go. Almost finished time. I want to know that it made it easier on you and the people. Got everyone trained to pray for Bishop Tom. Make sure that when you sign your paperwork, it's Tom W. and Alderman Tom S. Okay? It'll run a job you're going into. Challenges, joys, sorrows. Real easy times and some very difficult times. One of the former Archbishop of Canada said of Bishop Tom, if everyone loves you, if everyone respects you, if everyone agrees with you, then you're not doing your job. The one thing I remember at the time of my tenure as the presiding bishop is that you need to be true to yourself and to the message of Jesus Christ. That is an easy chore, to say the least, especially when you are involved in this independent movement. Now, if you're part of mainstream religions, you are held accountable to all their dictates, dogmas, current opinions, authority, and teachings as it was presently given to the people. Now, in the independent movement, it's totally different. Independent means just that. Independent. Our clergy and our people think outside the box. Our clergy and our people will differ with one another, but hold one thing in common. That is the message of Jesus Christ is found in the New Testament. It's found in the lessons we've learned from our early church fathers and mothers. And just because you don't agree doesn't mean you don't belong to us. Rather, it means you're losing your God-given ability to think and have your to how you react to many of the traditions and the attitudes of the people and the authority of his time. He hated sinners, he forgave prostitutes, and had them joined in the very man. He raised the dead for life, he cast money moves out of the temple. He would rather help a person in need than attend the synagogue to prevent seeing the person's life. We need to remember that we are a New Testament people, us independents. We don't and we won't slip and slap in our message just through our convenience or our lifestyle. We will always question the actions of others, including ourselves, not just to cause problems, but to hold each other accountable to the pure message. You know, being a bishop of this type of man is challenging, but very exciting, and very much what keeps us aware of our pastoral responsibilities. We need to always stay on the grind at all times, even though we're being said they go against the grain of what we personally believe. But what is very necessary in all of this is one other issue that I think has all brought the majority into a downward spiral of our clergy and our bishops, and that is our spiritual life. Live a great spiritual life, and you will find yourself close to the Lord and close to His people.
God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies and God of all consolation, who dwell on high, who look upon the morning, who know all things before they come to thee. It is you who established order in the church through your gracious word, who from the beginning predestined a righteous people, born of Abraham, who instituted rulers and priests, and did not leave your sanctuary without ministry, who from the beginning of the world have passed and been pleased to be glorified in those you have chosen. Now pour forth the power of this chosen one, the power that is from you, the government of the Spirit, whom you gave to your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, and whom he gave to the holy apostles, who established the church in each place as your sanctuary, to the glory and fulfilling praise of your name. Great, O Father, door of all hearts, that this is from whom you have chosen, for the Episcopate, may nourish your holy flock, and may the love of those exercise before you the high priesthood, serving you night and day, that he may unceasingly try to cause your faithful servant upon us, and offer the gifts of your holy church. Great is my strength and spirit of the high priesthood. He may have authority to forgive sins according to your command. He may appropriation of offices according to your precepts, and loose the every burden according to the authority you gave the apostles. May he be pleasing to you in godliness and purity of heart, offering a sweet fragrance to you, your Son Jesus Christ, whom our glory and power and honor are yours, the Holy Spirit, the Holy Church, with God and Father.
Amen.
May God, who made you a share of the high priest of Christ, himself pour out upon you the oil of mystical anointing, and make you fruitful with an abundance of spiritual blessings. Bishop Turner, receive the gospel and preach the word of God with all patience and sound teaching. have received this ring, the seal of fidelity, and adorned with undefiled faith, preserved unblemished, the bride of God, the Holy Church. Receive this ring, and let the splendor of holiness shine in you, so that when the chief shepherd appears, you may merit to receive the unfading crown of glory. Receive the crown. It is the sign of your pastoral office. The keep watch over the whole flock, in which the Holy Spirit has placed you as bishop to govern the Church of God.
Thank you. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread and water, which earth has given and human hands have made. Let it become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, bread of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
Holy Father, whose Son chose to wash the disciples' feet and so set us an example, accept, we pray, the oblations of our service, and grant that, offering ourselves as a spiritual sacrifice, we may be filled with the spirit of humility and zeal. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
As in an exaltation we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Father, you are holy indeed, and all creation rightly gives you praise. All life, all holiness comes from you through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, by the working of the Holy Spirit. From age to age you gather a people to yourself, so that from east to west a perfect offering may be made to the glory of your name. And so, Father, we bring you these gifts. We ask you to make them holy by the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this Eucharist. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread and gave you thanks and praise, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. When supper was ended, he took the cup again. Thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that when we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your love, O Lord, until you come again.
Grant that we who are nourished by his body and blood may be filled with the Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make us an everlasting gift to you and enable us to share the eternal heavenly inheritance of your saints with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, the martyrs, and all your saints, on whose constant intercession we rely for help.
Lord, may this sacrifice, which has made our peace with you, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, the Bishop of Rome, with James, our bishop, Thomas, our soon-to-be Bishop Emeritus, and me, your unworthy servant, who have been ordained today as shepherds of the National Catholic Church of North America. With the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own, listen graciously to the prayers of this family and that your son has gathered here before you. In mercy and love, unite all your children wherever they may be. Welcome into your kingdom, our departed brothers and sisters, and all who have left this world in friendship. We hope to enjoy forever the vision of your glory through Christ our Lord, from whom all good things come.
Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia.
Lord, may the Eucharist you have given us influence our thoughts and actions. May your Spirit guide and direct us in your way. We ask this in the name of Jesus, the Lord.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ the Lord.
Thanks
be to God.